Hello everyone. Today I'm here to talk to you about CO2 and all the possible ways you can get CO2 into your planted aquarium. Why is CO2 so important? Photosynthesis is the most basic process a plant does. And during photosynthesis, plants convert CO2, carbon dioxide, into oxygen. If nutrients are their food, then CO2 is their drink. It's so vital for plants to grow. Some plants need more, some plants need less. Don't get me wrong, you can build a really nice aquascape without CO2 injection if you have the correct plant choices. But even those less demanding plants will be grateful if you provide additional CO2 for them. And you can have an easier time fighting against algae, which is always part of our life. The most basic CO2 system you can get is a yeast-based bio CO2 system. These are available from multiple brands like Tropica, Danella, Aquario. The basic principle is mixing yeast with gelatin and sugar and water, and it starts to produce CO2 chemically. It's the very same process that you have when you are kneading dough, when you're making bread or pizza dough or whatever. It's a CO2 starts to generate from this mix, and that's what makes your dough rise. Now, when we are looking at the pros of this kind of system, is it's really easy to get into and it's inexpensive compared to all the other versions, but the pros stop there. The cons, however, are a longer list. These systems are not adjustable. You have a simple chemical reaction. It goes as it goes. You have no say in how much CO2 gets into your tank. Because of this, you are quite limited on the aquarium size where you can use this. This type of system is useful for up to 20, 30 liters of aquarium. And we use it in our showroom as well on our 20 or 30 liter Danella nano cubes from time to time, because they're perfectly enough for having simple carpeting plants and providing enough CO2 for them. The second disadvantage is these systems are highly depending on temperature. They work anywhere between 20 and 30 degrees Celsius, but even in that range, the hotter it gets, the quicker the chemical reaction is, so the more CO2 you produce. The colder it gets, the reaction gets slower and you get less CO2. And again, you don't really have any control about this, except for controlling your room temperature perfectly, which you don't really want to do for your CO2 setup. You want to get comfortable yourself in your home. These systems work 24/7. You have no option for shutting them off during the night, which is mostly how we use the other CO2 injection systems we have. And it works for about 30 to 50 days with one refill package. But even in that time, you need to manually refill or do the mixture again two or three times. So you have to fiddle around quite a lot with the system to work. But to sum it up, it's a perfect way to get into using CO2, to try CO2 and see what it does for your aquarium and see the advantages without spending lots and lots of money into a proper CO2 system. Your next option, and we're still sticking to smaller aquariums, are CO2 systems with disposable bottles, like the Tropica Nano set we have. It has a 95 gram bottle, so not a lot of CO2. The way it works would actually be enough for even 200 liters of aquarium, but with the 95 grams, you would run out of CO2 really quickly and you would need to exchange the bottle very, very often. So that's why we usually recommend this type of sets up to 30, 40 liters, just like the previous one. But again, it's relatively inexpensive compared to the rest. It's more stable than the yeast-based because you have actual CO2 filled into a bottle, so you are not relying on a chemical reaction anymore. It doesn't need too much space, and it also looks nice. So these kind of setups are perfect for your kitchen table aquarium, or if you have a small nano tank on your office desk and you don't really have space and you want something that is nice to look at. And in a small tank, you need to change the bottle every 2 or 3 months, so it's not that much of a work to deal with it. But in the long run, it's not cost effective because you are throwing away your bottle and you buy a new one instead. So these are not refillable, and that cost adds up in years to come. Your third option, and this is where we get into sort of the high pressure versions, is the citric acid based system. And this is a chemical reaction based system, just like the yeast one, but it uses citric acid mixed with baking soda and water to get the chemical reaction going. And it's made in a cylinder that actually can hold proper pressure. So you get the same kind of pressure that you would get with a normal big pressurized system. The pros are that this is really easy to use. It's easy to do the mixture. You just mix the certain amounts that are given. You can control the bubble count quite easily, which you can do with the disposable bottles as well, but not as finely as you want to. You can already use a solenoid valve or pH controller to shut off your system, which is highly recommended instead of running it 24/7. And it lasts longer than any of the other methods mentioned before. Now for cons, I can only compare it with a high pressure system. Compared to that, you need to do manual refilling, which is, if you are into DIY stuff, then it's fine. If you're not, it can get uncomfortable. It's not even really a con. It's, I think, up to personal preference if you want to play around with that or not. But it can be a really good solution if you don't have a good option for refilling your CO2, because that can get tricky. If you have a proper system, your CO2 cylinder needs to be refilled from time to time. And that's, if you live in an area where that's not a simple thing to do, then this type of biosystem is much simpler. Now, if I look at that logic of it being difficult to refill your CO2 cylinders, the small cylinder setups are good as well, where you have exchangeable cylinders. This is like the Danella soda stream setup, where you use an actual soda stream cylinder, which is available on any bigger grocery store. You can just go in, exchange it to a refilled one, you leave the empty one there, and that's it. All the rest of this kind of setup is the very same as it would be on a proper old school pressurized system. So the only difference is the cylinder itself, and of course the pressure reducer that goes on top, which is compatible with a soda stream cylinder. Again, I would recommend this if it's difficult for you to get a proper CO2 cylinder filled, but I would draw a limit at about 60 or 80 liters, because soda stream cylinders are 400 grams. Now, that goes to about 2 or 3 months on 60 liters, and then you need a refill or need an exchange, to be precise. And you want your system to run longer if you can. You don't want to fiddle around with it every 2 or 3 months. But again, if you don't have the option for proper refill, then this can give you a really good way around it. And then we arrive to the proper old school pressurized systems, where you have an industrial CO2 bottle, 2 kilograms, 5 kilograms, 10, 20, whatever you can get and whatever is comfortable for your aquarium size. With these kind of setups, it's recommended to choose the perfect items yourself. Like, for example, if you go at the Green Aqua website, we have CO2 systems where you can select what type of pressure reducer you want, what solenoid valve you want, what kind of check valve you want. You can get around choosing your own items instead of choosing a pre-made set, which are also available, but usually have some drawbacks on the diffuser they give, the bubble counter they give. I think it's much better to choose your own items. The most important thing is that these are the most stable setups you can get. You set this up once for your tank and you don't need to adjust it even when you refill your bottle. You just take it off and put it back on, and that's it. Find the perfect level of CO2 once, which can take a few days, but after that, there's nothing to do. And now when you choose the size of your cylinder, you need to make sure that it fits your cabinet or the space you have for it. And you need to think about how often you want to, or how often you're gonna need to do a refill. Now for that, a 2 kilogram bottle can last up to 8 to 10 months on a 60 liter aquarium. This is a good base to calculate what kind of, or what size of cylinder you would want to get. Also, these type of systems are usually much more precise than any of the other, because if you buy a high level, a good quality pressure reducer, it usually comes with a needle valve that is really finely adjustable. So you can get that perfect level of CO2 much easier than on any cheap systems where the needle valve can be quite tricky to set up because they would just move it slightly and then bubble count increases dramatically. If you buy the proper items, then this won't happen and you can have perfect control over your CO2 levels. But this time, you're gonna need to find a solution for refilling your CO2 bottle. Now, it's really important. For example, at Green Aqua, it works in a way that you buy your CO2 cylinder and then you bring it back to us when it's empty and we don't refill it in place, we give you another one as a refill. So the bottle itself is not yours. And that's how it works for most companies. If you don't have that near you, you don't have an aquarium shop that does this near you, you can still ask around with your friends because the CO2 we use is the very same that car mechanics use for welding or what bars and restaurants use for beer taps. CO2 is CO2, it doesn't make a difference. So if you can't really figure out where to do your refills, just ask around friends who work in these kind of businesses and maybe they're gonna have a solution for you. Sadly, these type of cylinders usually look quite industrial. There is a way around it as well. You can buy nice looking aluminium bottles, but then you won't do the exchange. You need to get that actually refilled for yourself, which is again a bit more tricky to find a place that will do that for you. Now, these are the systems themselves. And there are a few things we need to talk about which are optional or depend on the aquarium size. I said multiple system that you can use it on a small tank or a big tank or whatever size, for example, with the proper pressurized system. It doesn't matter, you can use it on 30 liters or you can use it on 600 liters. The only thing that's going to be different is the actual method of injecting CO2 in your aquarium water. Now, for small tanks, we usually use internal diffusers. You've seen this, you see the bubbles in your aquarium. That's something you either like or you don't, but with a small tank, there's not much wiggle room to go about. On slightly bigger tanks, you can go with external atomizers, which are small ceramic units that go into your filter hoses, and you get your CO2 injected into the filtered water and it goes back to the aquarium. You're still gonna see some bubbles floating around, but it's a more effective way of dissolving CO2 than a regular diffuser. And for big tanks, and we usually say anything above 200 liters, we always recommend using an external reactor where you have a bigger unit, again, in your filter line, your filter hose, and there are small plastic balls inside the reactor itself, which crash the CO2 into your water. So when the water comes back to the aquarium itself, you don't see bubbles anymore. 100% of the CO2 is dissolved into the water. And this is the most effective way, but it only works with bigger filters, so it only works on bigger aquariums. And then you need to decide on how you want or when you want CO2 to be injected. And there's two ways you can go. Some people run it by time, by photoperiod of the plants, basically. This means we inject CO2 during lighting periods, actually a bit before. So your lights come on 3 p.m. and turn off 10 p.m. For this kind of setup, we would start running CO2 at 1 p.m., so 2 hours before the lighting period starts. So there is already CO2 in the water itself by the time the light comes on. And the CO2 turns off together with the lights at 10 p.m. And during the night, we don't inject any CO2 into the tank. The plants themselves take up oxygen instead of carbon dioxide in the night, so there's no need to run the CO2. The other way you can go is using a pH controller where you dose CO2 based on the pH level of the aquarium. Now, let's say you want a pH level of 6.5 in your tank. Normally the tank itself would go up. It starts climbing the pH. It reaches 6.6. Then the CO2 comes on, and as CO2 gets dissolved in the water, it starts to drop your pH level. So it starts decreasing, it reaches 6.4, then the CO2 stops and it starts to rise again. It basically works like your thermostat for room temperature. It's the same principle. It tries to keep it on a certain level by letting CO2 go in or stopping CO2 whenever it needs to. Now there is a way to mix the two methods. For example, with the new Eheim digital CO2 controller, which has a bio mode, which means you can set a different level of pH for the day and a different level of pH for the night. So, for example, we run our 650 at the moment in a way that we have an aim of pH for 6.4 during the day and 6.7 during the night. This way, we can make sure that the pH can't climb too high during the night, it will still be controlled, but we don't dissolve CO2 without the plants taking it up, or at least not too much CO2 into the tank. I hope this video helps to clear up your choices on CO2. You don't need to be afraid of CO2, because a lot of people are. They think the whole tank is going to be more complicated once they introduce CO2. But you're going to have a lot more options on plants. You're going to have an easier time against algae, and you're going to have nicer looking plants, even if they are the types that don't actually require additional CO2. That's it for today. If you like this content, please subscribe. If you have any questions, drop it in the comments below, and see you next time. Goodbye.